हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज हरजीत सिंह, लेक्चरर कंप्यूटर साइंस डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ थापर पॉलिटेक्निक कॉलेज पटियाला। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर इंट्रोडक्शन टू मल्टीमीडिया। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग अवर टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज अवर प्रीवियस कंटेंट्स। सो अवर प्रीवियस कंटेंट दैट वी हैव डन इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डन विद डेफिनेशन ऑफ मल्टीमीडिया। So definition of multimedia, like it is the combination of text, image, audio and video which you use to deliver our information with more effective way. Next we have done with elements of multimedia. There are basically five or six types of elements of multimedia, that is text, image, graphic, audio, video and animation. Then types of multimedia. There are basically two types of multimedia, linear multimedia and non-linear multimedia. Then after that, multimedia authoring tools. There are basically four types of multimedia authoring tools: Macromedia Flash, Microsoft PowerPoint, Macromedia AuthorWare, Micromedia Director. So these are the topics that we have done in our previous lecture. So let's start with our today's session. So in today's session, we discuss the benefits of multimedia, then applications of multimedia, then career in multimedia and animation, animation techniques, then importance of multimedia, and last one is problem with multimedia. So let's start with this topic in detail. First is benefits of multimedia. So there are number of benefits of multimedia in every field, because in today's nowadays multimedia is used in every field. So there are a lot of benefits of multimedia. Let's start with the common benefits of multimedia. First is it addresses multiple learning styles. It provides the different styles modes, learning styles mode in different fields. Then provides an excellent way to convey our message. There are a different way we can use audio, we can use video and text also for represent our content. So next is that it provide a use a variety of media elements to reinforce one idea. So there are a number of different elements to represent one idea in different way. Next is that it give a life to flat information. There are a use of proper information in multimedia. Then it enhance the user enjoyment. User can enjoy their topic with the different ideas and different ways by using the multimedia. Then it improve the retentions. Then it enables users to control the web experience. So there are these are the benefits of multimedia. Then after that, applications of multimedia. So when we discuss the applications of multimedia, we can see that in every field today's multimedia is used in every field nowadays. So there are a common multimedia applications we can see here. First is multimedia in business. So we can use in multimedia in business with various aspects, like multimedia. We can use multimedia in business for representing our idea, our technical support with our training, employments, employees, representation, presentation, training, marketing, advertisement, and products, demos, database, catalogs, and network communications. So multimedia is getting much utilization in training programs. Also, it play a very important role in business. Next one is multimedia in schools. So we nowadays multimedia playing very important role in education system. So we can say schools are most important area or targeted field of multimedia. It provide the different way, like online study materials and online lectures provide to the students. So there is a no need to availability of the student at same time with the teachers. So student can use the multimedia or recording lectures to at their own pace and with their own time. So there is no physical presence in the class. Students can learning while having a fun. So during we also discussed that this time during COVID-19, multimedia playing very, very important role in education system, because nowadays education classes, online classes going through multimedia. So we can say that multimedia playing very important role in education system. Then after that, multimedia at home. We use multimedia at home in different ways, like from cooking to grading home design to repair intended. Multimedia has made itself useful at home. We can use multimedia at home with like lights on off, automatic fan on off, automatic sensors. So there are a number of parts or number of fields at home that we can use multimedia. So today's multimedia is also being applicable in our TV, and so multimedia projects will reach at homes via interactive TV, IETV, we can say IETV. Then multimedia in public places. So multimedia is also playing a very important role in public places like railway, airports, stand terminals, and museums, grocery stores, and etc. It provides a useful information and help about the particular place. Interactive kiosks enable you to make a transaction without talking to sale agents. So it provides a lot of benefits to user in public places. So this is the also important benefits of multimedia. Next one is multimedia in the internet. So with the help of internet, we use a multimedia during online availability of the content and resources in different topics and different fields. Then online videos, games, e-learning courses. So we can use the internet we can use the multimedia with the help of internet. We can see the online videos, we can play online games, e-learning courses at their own place. So it plays a important role. So then after that, online study materials. There are a lot of study material available on the internet. We can use that material. So after that, multimedia in mobile devices. We can use our mobile in multimedia in the use of MMS, multimedia messaging services, message service, text message, email. We can send email one place to another place. Then after, we can transmitting audio and video clips from one place to another place, or one mobile to another mobile, and calling and recording. Then various applications for different uses. For example, WhatsApp. We use WhatsApp for communication. We can share our information, documents, audio and video files with the use of multimedia. Then after that, multimedia in electronic commerce or e-commerce. So multimedia playing very important role in e-commerce, online sale and purchase. For example, there are a lot of sites, online sites like Flipkart, Amazon's. So they use these sites use the e-commerce, online sale and purchase. We can sale anytime, we can purchase anytime our product on online marketing. And after that, advertisement. So we can advertise online. So with the use of different modes, like social sites, Facebook, WhatsApp status. So we can advertise our product with the help of multimedia. Online technical supports, that is customer relationship. Then after that, multimedia in research and references. So in research and references, application there are a number of applications that are used for that research purpose, like online newspaper, newsletters, magazines, books, encyclopedia, and other references material are being offered via web. So it provides an electronic version also for exciting research and reference materials. So, and increasing a number of self-help and how to guide are being offered as interactive multimedia applications on the web. So we can use that applications for our research purpose or our other references also. So there are online tools available on internet. We can use that online that tools for implementing our algorithms. So it plays a very important role in research and references. Next is the topic of career in multimedia and animations. So there are different fields in set our careers. First one is management related positions, production related positions, then art related positions, then content related positions. Let's discuss in detail all these career positions. First one is management related positions. First one is executive producer. So we can make our career as a executive producer, who move a project into and through productions. Then project manager, we can be a project manager, which is responsible for forming a project, moving it into production and overseeing its creation. Then audio specialist, we can make our career as an audio specialist who is responsible for editing sound effect, voice over, vocal and transitional sounds, recording, editing and selecting voice, sounds and music, and then computer programmer. So it creates underlying codes that makes a website interactive and responsive to the user's actions. Then video specialist, we can be a video specialist, manage the process of capturing, editing the original video and apply the more attractive effects on the video. Then production related positions, web designer, we can be a web designer, web developer also. So web developer ensure the communication between the front and the website and its back end is working. And web designer is responsible or refines a design processing and efficiently create a cohesive and well-planned website front end from the front end. Then webmaster, it is responsible for making sure the web page is technically correct and functional on the web server. So after that, art related positions, we can set our career in art related positions also, like animation specialist. We can create 3D, 2D animations by taking a sequence of static images and displaying them in rapid succession on the computer screen. Then art director, we can be art director, coordinate the creations of artwork for the project. Then graphic artist, designer, creating and designing all the graphics images for the projects. Then interface designer. So there are tools available for designing interface their own choice according to the user requirement. So it is the responsibility of interface designer to responsible for the look of the website interface and navigation methods. Then photographer shoots and capture appropriate compelling and high quality photos. Then videographer shoots and capture appropriate compelling and high quality video footage. So these are the like opportunities we can set our careers by using multimedia. So then content related positions, content specialist. So there are a lot of fields or a lot of information available on the internet or by using multimedia, so providing authenticity and accuracy of information on the website. So this is the responsibility of content specialist. Then instruction specialist, expert in designing instruction projects. Then writers, editors, technical writers, script writers, creative writers, and journalists involved in the projects. So these are the opportunities in the content related positions. Then animation techniques. So there are mainly two types of animation techniques that we have used in industry. First one is cell based animation, or we called cell animation. Next is the computer animation. So both of these animations are popular on television. So let's start with discussion on detail cell based animation. This animation technique is basically used to develop animated cartoon videos. So if we are going to make a cartoon video, so then we will use the cell based animation. In cell based animation, the working is done by the frame, or working is done on the frame during making a cartoon video. The frames are made up of clear celluloid sheets. So these type of animation play 24 frames per second. So user can fill colors and create line arts in animation as per their own choice. Then after that, computer animation. This technique is same as cell animation to create animation. So there is a little bit difference on the working or implementing the animation techniques on the like frame or layers. In previous technique, like cell-based techniques, in which we works on frame, but in computer animation we works on layers. The only difference is that we uses layers, keyframes, and twinning method to create animation. So these animations are created in special software that consists of basic features to select, edit, and format drawing objects. Then importance of multimedia. So there are a number of like concept that shows the importance of multimedia. First one is ease of use. It is user friendly, increase user's effectiveness. Then attractive graphical user interface. It allow a user to create graphical user interface according to their own choice, according to the requirement of customer. Then self-paced interaction and better retention. So there is no restriction that availability content on B time, allow information processing at own pace and time. Then better understanding. It provides a better information regarding various topics and elements. Then we can use internet media for that purpose also. Cost effectiveness. So it requires a less technical support and training. So these are the importance of multimedia. Then problems with multimedia. There are a number of can say disadvantages or problems of multimedia. First one is investment cost. It requires a high volume of content that is most costly. Then expensive copyright and royalty. Then technical issues. There are some technical issues when we use a multimedia, like portability issues, compatibility issues, upgradation issues, like we need to update our software time to time. So then after that, psychological problems like generation gap, learning in groups, and individual problems. This is the common problem, like some person like learning in groups and some likes individual. So this is also a problem of multimedia. Then misuse of multimedia on social sites, as we can see nowadays, there are a number of fields where we use the misuse of multimedia. So then after that, legal problems like copyrights. So these are the problems of multimedia. Then after that, important questions from the today's session. So there are a number of important questions. Like first is explain various computer animations, working of computer animation, like how the computer animation is working. So as we discussed in our previous slides, computer animation working on layers. Then what are the various applications of multimedia? There are a number of applications of multimedia. We can use multimedia in every field. Then after that, explain different types of animations. Then what are the advantages and disadvantages of multimedia? So these are the important questions. So thanks for watching.